Oh, G2.
Dr. Ghez, what are you doing?
We're making a list of stars that we might want to observe tonight.
Oh, can we interrupt you for 37 questions?
Absolutely.
Before you go, does this look like an eclipsing binary?
Oh, this looks great. We should definitely add it to the list.
What did you want to be growing up?
I wanted to be an astronaut. I wanted to be a dancer. There were a lot of things that I thought I might want to be when I grew up.
Is it true that you wanted to be the first woman in space?
That is the family lore.
So how did you end up being such a successful astronomer?
A lot of curiosity, a lot of optimism, and definitely some luck.
How many stars are in our galaxy?
There are 100 billion stars in our galaxy.
What's your favorite place here on Earth?
My favorite place on Earth is Hawaii, because that's where the Keck telescopes are.
What was your favorite book as a kid?
My favorite book was Nancy Drew, because she was an awesome detective.
Why can't we see the center of the galaxy in the winter?
We can't see the center of the galaxy, because if this is the center of the galaxy over here, and this is our sun, and this is the Earth going around the sun, obviously this is not to scale. In the winter, when we look to the center of the galaxy, we look in the direction of the sun. But in the summer, when we look in that direction, we don't have to be bothered with the sun.
Have you ever hung out with royalty?
Only once.
What's so special about astronomy at UCLA?
Well, UCLA co-owns the largest telescope in the world, and at UCLA, we develop methods and instruments for infrared astronomy. So if you're an infrared astronomer, this is just the place to be.
What would you say to a little girl who wants to be an astronomer?
Oh, go for it.
Excuse me, do you know where the sculpture garden is?
Oh, that's my favorite place on campus, but you're a little lost. It's up north.
Oh, okay, thank you.
What's one myth about black holes?
That they're cosmic vacuum cleaners.
So are we going to get sucked into the black hole at the center of our galaxy?
No, we won't get sucked in. We are very far away. We're out in the suburbs of our galaxy.
Are there any Hollywood movies that get it right about black holes?
Interstellar did a great job, but I'm a little biased because I got to partake in parts of it.
Have we ever tested our theory of gravity near a black hole?
We haven't, and that's one of the things that we want to do with our studies of the center of the galaxy.
Will you play a game of tic-tac-toe with me?
Oh, I would love to play tic-tac-toe. You let me start.
I'm going to beat you.
Maybe. I love puzzles. Oh, cast game.
You beat me.
Oh, I did? Excellent. I didn't even see.
That's. Do you have a favorite star?
SO2. It's my favorite star because it's told us most about the center of the galaxy.
What does SO2 stand for?
S because it's in the constellation of Sagittarius, and 2 because it was the second closest to the center of the galaxy when we discovered it.
Why is it important to understand the universe?
It's important you understand the universe because we're curious, we live in it, and in fact there are conditions in the universe that can't be replicated here, so it really gives us a different understanding of the physics of the universe.
How can the rest of us see the impact of astronomy?
Well, if you have a smartphone and you like to use Google or Waze, you can only position yourself that well for those programs to work by general relativity being understood.
Why is it called the Milky Way?
It's called the Milky Way because we live in our galaxy, and our galaxy is a flattened disk-like structure, and we live halfway out. So when we look in, up in the sky and see the plane of the Milky Way, it looks like a plane of light, like a stream of milk, and hence the Milky Way.
Wait, do you like Milky Way bars?
I do like Milky Way bars, especially the dark ones, the midnight specials.
How can you observe a black hole from here at UCLA?
Well, we use the Keck telescope, and this is the Keck remote observing room, so we get to use the telescope here from campus, even though it's in Hawaii.
Andrea, what are you doing tonight? Central pointing or Mesa Mosaic?
Well, it depends on the weather.
What is the weather in Hawaii?
Well, Devin can probably tell us here.
Weather looks good.
That picture from the satellite looks fantastic.
So what does all this equipment do?
Well, all this equipment here allows us to use the Keck telescope, which is out in Hawaii. These screens will control the instruments, and then this screen will connect us to the folks up at the summit who will control the pointing of the telescope.
What's the formula for gravity?
The formula for gravity, well, the one we're using today, is that the force of gravity is a gravitational constant times the mass of the black hole times the mass of the star divided by the distance between them squared. That's what we use today, but in fact, we want to get beyond this. We want to be able to test Einstein's version of this equation.
Do you teach a class about black holes?
I do. I teach intro astronomy for undergraduates.
What's your hidden talent?
Oh, I like baking cookies.
What's your favorite TV show?
My favorite TV show is Once Upon a Time. I love watching it with my kids.
What can students look forward to in your class?
My students can look forward to a trip to Mount Wilson, which is where there are a lot of telescopes.
What does it all mean, really?
Well, it all means that we live in a very large universe that's been around for a very long time, and it's amazing that we get to understand it.
Would you mind holding the sign up for us?
Sure.
Thank you, Dr. Ghez.
You're welcome. It's been lots of fun.